Hey guys, I'm Mickey Mouse back here from the video. Guys, today we're going to talk about all the ways I've been making coins off this brand new free agent promo. Now, I did a video yesterday on the channel, on the second channel, talking about how to make coins. Guys, not check that out, go check it out. But we're going to kind of relittle some of the things we talked about in that video and kind of go on from there. But starting off right away, just the basic thing I covered in that video, but I'll just say it right here, is that you want to go ahead and complete the solo challenges. If you complete the solos, you do get a 96 overall player for free. Now, that's not the way to make coins, because obviously the free player, does that really matter? No, it does not matter, because it's NAT. But what you can do is, once you get that 96 overall player, instead of keeping it, because in all honesty, there's no point to keep the player, because most of the players honestly are not that good. The only player that's actually pretty good is Hunter Henry. So, but let me hear me out here. So what you can go ahead and do is go to the free agency promo right here. Go ahead and go into the Dak Prescott or the JJ Watt one. Right now, the best one to do is Dak Prescott, because he's the most money. But once you get a 96 overall, you can complete this Dak Prescott set for half price. So instead of spending, you know, 500,000 coins, 600,000 coins for two players, you can complete this set for roughly around 250,000-260,000 coins. And in my video yesterday, I showed you guys that these cards are being posted up every single second. I'm doing this video at 2 a.m., so they're not going to be as good posted, but they were being posted, and they're still going to be posted for 250, 260. Right now, they're actually down. Wow, I did not know they were so much down in price. But now they're down to 245. So again, you can probably get that even cheaper, 230. Earlier today, it was like 260. Now it's probably 230, maybe 225. You just got to kind of go over to the auction house. And here's the filters I would use to try to get some snipes here, guys, just to go ahead and get these even cheaper. But once you go ahead and do that, again, you're spending maybe 220, 230K for, you know, that's to complete that set, and you get back a Dak Prescott. If we look at Dak Prescott's price tag right now, I think he's around 450,000 coins last time I checked, and he's going to be dropping more and more as the day goes on, as more and more people complete these solos. Because the solos are very easy to complete, in all honesty. Right now, he's 417. So again, 417, you're going to spend around 200,000 coins on it. That's not a bad way to make some decent coins real fast. Just flip around. I mean, and if you want to, hey, if you want to go ahead, you make 160,000 coin profit. Again, like I said, most people are not going to keep the cards, the 96 overalls. So a nice 160K. Now, of course, yesterday was even better. Yesterday was like a 250K profit, 200K profit. It has come down in value a little bit because a lot of people are doing this, in all honesty. So free agency, though, let's go ahead and talk about sniping these cards, because you can snipe these cards for cheaper and get this set done for cheaper. So what we know is we're looking at right ends. We're looking at free safeties. We're looking at halfbacks. We're looking at wide receivers, and I think that is actually it. Yeah, okay, cornerback too. So all you're gonna do is set up the set it up just like you see on the screen right here, and then you can see right there, 250K, cheapest one up, bam, get that one. But free agency, 96, 97, and then go by each single position. Now, the reason why we set it, you know, as you guys know, we usually set it to the newest player available. The reason why we're not doing that now is because there's just not enough up, really, to be a big deal. I'm going to see the newest one as the cheapest price. Usually we do that when there's a lot of cards up and we're trying to see the newest card posted. But in this situation, because there's not too many posted, it's actually going to be just probably easier just to do it by now, so you can kind of see the cheapest one up. And I've been doing this, I was doing this earlier today, and it's actually a really, really good method, because first off, when you do this method, right, if that you're gonna get cards posted for, like, again, keep in mind tax, EA tax is the biggest thing about this method. Okay, now I was doing this, completing the set and then selling off JJ Watt or Dak Prescott. That's what I was doing. But you can do this and just flip the card and, you know, resell the card, snipe the card. But I recommend, if you're doing this, probably do this to go ahead and complete the set. Main reason why I got 244K, because you're going to see, yes, you can, theoretically speaking, you know, make profit off this, doing this, like flipping the cards. It's just really a lot more difficult, and you're going to have to get a little bit more lucky. So, for example, in order to make a profit on this, this card most likely will sell for 262 most of the time, right? So what we know that is that we have to get a card below 240K, about around below 240K And if we can get below 240, 235, we can snipe these cards and actually flip them and sell them back. But I would honestly recommend, like I said, at that point, just completing the set. 230K. Actually, sorry. Dang, I didn't realize how cheap he was. Never mind, not completing the set. Probably, well, completing the set if you have the NAT 96 overall. But probably going ahead and just, That's crazy. His price is actually really low in that Dak Prescott. His price is now very, very low. So honestly, probably if you are going to snipe these again, like I said, for the set, for completing the solos and then doing the set, do this method. But if you are trying to go ahead and make some coins off this promo when it comes to sniping, I reckon probably not sniping the higher overall cards like this. I'd probably go ahead and stay clear of these cards in all honesty, because it even if you got it for like 200K, it's still not going to make you profitable for completing the set. So it's not really profitable when it comes to completing the set there. So the other set we have is going to be, of course, the 94 overall set, or 92, 94 overall set in what's it called over here in set. So let's go ahead and take a look at that one. So free agency right here, go to exchange over here, and we have this 92 to 94 overall set right here. Now this second set, by the way, is an absolute waste of coins. I know, honestly, it's an absolute waste of coins. And this one is actually a waste of coins too, because in order to complete the set, it's going to cost you around 100,000 coins, but you can complete this set for a lot less. Now, on face value, it's a waste of coins, but if you do go ahead and complete the set for a lot less, let's say you do get some good snipes on these cards, you could, theoretically speaking, break even to make coins. I just don't like it personally. I talked about this in the video, and again, I just don't like this set at all. I think it's a really, really bad set. It just doesn't make you it doesn't have any upside. If they made a 96 overall, I think it would be a lot better, in all honesty, but definitely not something I recommend going for. Now let's talk about the packs in the store, because packs in the store right here, the training packs, I don't think training priority is updated for these cards yet. You can't get these cards out of training priority. These right here. Now, I've opened up both of these one time. I put a 93 overall, and I actually opened this one time, actually. 89 overall. So, was it... are they worth it? Now, we're going to wait to see the kind of spins come out and all the stuff come out about these packs and seeing, like, you know, what are the odds of pulling blank, 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 blank. But based on what I see and based on what I've seen, I definitely say no. I would not go with these. I think it's going to be a waste of coins, a waste of time. It's just not one I would go after. Now, I don't think any of those have ever been worth it except for like a couple months ago. I know that the Super Bowl one was kind of worth it in a way. It was a decent value. I got a lot of good pulls out of that, but I just wasn't, you know, doing too good. Now, outside of that, again, there's not really any other ways to make coins off this exact promo, which is kind of sad, because I was kind of hoping them for there to be more ways to make coins, especially with how this promo was set up and how it came off of the Mutt Heroes promo. And the Mutt Heroes promo, honestly, again, like I said, still not done yet, guys. The Mutt Heroes promo is still going on. We're going to get another update on 3/19, 3 days from now, and then an update on the 26th with new solos, new objective list that gives you another, you know, 300,000 coins each one. So again, a lot of new more stuff coming out in the near future, but kind of disappointing on this promo not having too many ways to make coins. But guys, tell me down below your thoughts and opinions, and I'll see you guys next one. Peace out.